Hey everyone, today I'm going to be reviewing, unboxing, and demoing this Yuking Party Laser that I found on Amazon. So I've been wanting to rethink and revamp my wedding and mobile DJ light shows. So I've been studying concerts, nightclubs, festivals, and just seeing some of their lighting techniques and seeing how I can apply that to my own shows. And I've been noticing that one really important group of lights that are present in those shows aren't present in a lot of wedding and mobile light shows, and that is lasers. And there's three really good reasons for that. Lasers are paired best with haze machines or fog machines, and a lot of venues don't allow for that. Photographers hate lasers. There was a viral article where a photographer said a laser shone at her camera lens, and it broke her camera sensor. It permanently damaged it. It was an expensive repair to repair the sensor. I mean, even at my last wedding, a photographer came up to me and was like, "Do you have any lasers as part of your light show? If you do, I request that you not use them." And, you know, I cheekily responded, "Yes, I do have lasers, and I'll make it a point to shine it directly in your camera just to break it." So she got a good chuckle out of that, but seriously, photographers don't like lasers. And third, in the US, most lasers require a variance to operate, which means bureaucratic paperwork that you have to file every single time you want to use the laser at a gig. Yeah, so that's a hassle and a half. So lasers that are 5 milliwatts and above require to variance to operate. And just for context, a Gig Bar 2 comes equipped with a 4.99 milliwatt laser. A lot of people complain that it's really weak, but that is the most powerful laser you can operate without needing government paperwork legally. So I might make another video talking about laser variances in general, but I mean, it's for safety, because if a laser can shine in a camera and break the sensor, you can shine it in someone's eyes and you can break their eyes. You can make people potentially go blind. And another thing to clarify is that you don't need a variance to operate a laser in the privacy of your own home. So it isn't immediately clear how powerful this laser is. I looked in the manual, I looked at the website, and it doesn't say. It says it's a class 3B laser, so it means it does need a variance to operate, but usually you need a variance prior to purchasing a laser that needs a variance to operate, so I'm not quite sure. But whatever the case, prioritize safety. Do not shine this in people's eyes. Don't shine it in your own eyes. The manual has two pages full of safety instructions, so read them, familiarize yourself with it, follow it, and everybody can enjoy your pretty light shows without going blind. But all that said, lasers are cool, and I wanted to get a laser so I could play with it. So I didn't want to spend a ton of money, because I might not be using this at any shows. So I got myself this laser on Amazon for $170. And I wasn't expecting much, but this has blown my expectations. And I feel like this has the features and functionality of a much more expensive laser. So without further ado, let's unbox this thing and get on with the review. An IEC cable. A remote. A laser. Also comes with this handy dandy manual. So let's take a look at some of the features. Safety hatch. Somewhere to point the eye, a remote. A bracket to hang. So a physical on and off switch. Sensitivity for the sound active mode. A DMX in and a DMX out. And a display to change the different settings. It's unclear how powerful the laser is, but it's 20 watts power consumption. About 6¾ inches long. About 7.5 inches wide. 3.5 inches tall. And with the stand, 6.5 inches tall. Amazon lists this as 4.1 pounds, but I'm getting 3.2 pounds. A size comparison with a different laser. In my last show, I just used the dual clamp to clamp this, but in the future, I would use a normal lighting clamp. I'll have some links in the description below. All right, so let's go ahead and turn this on and go over the various modes of operation. So the first one is an auto mode. And the second one is a professional DMX mode, which has 34 channels and it gives you more control. And then there's simple DMX mode, which has 6 channels. So let's go over the auto modes real quick. So there's 3 different kinds of auto mode. So the first one is going to give you a bunch of shapes and dots. And this is the kind of patterns you'd expect to see from a stage or And remember, to get the full effect of a laser, you need a fog machine or a haze machine. And then I'm going to click up. So Bank 2 gives you a bunch of drawings, cartoon characters. There you got like a flower and a butterfly, dolphin, Winnie the Pooh. And you know, if you have like your nieces, your nephews, your children, this is probably the setting that they would find the most entertaining. I don't know, maybe not. All right, and then the third, so that's SE2. So this third bank includes shapes and drawings. So we'll alternate through all of its presets. So this does not have ILDA, so you can't plug it into software and create your own custom drawings or animations, which is definitely a limitation. But for the price, this is still really good. So yeah, that's basically auto mode. But if you want sound active mode, you click the enter button. You'll notice that there's a dot right here. And it'll respond to my voice a little bit. Sensitivity is all the way to the max. But here, tapping the top of it will trigger the sound active mode. All right, and for this part of the presentation, I'm gonna plug it into DMX. You don't have to use SoundSwitch, you can follow along with pretty much any software. But SoundSwitch does make it pretty easy because it just gives you a bunch of sliding scales for all the various parameters, but you could input it with any software you would like. So I am in A, which is the professional DMX mode, on channel 1, and I have everything set in my software. And I plugged in my DMX cable, and so it's good to go. All right, so in case you're not familiar with SoundSwitch, SoundSwitch lets you configure the various channels with something called an attribute queue. But these are 34 parameters, as you can see here, and you could configure this with literally any software. But this is just kind of a nice visual way to demonstrate it. So there's two projectors inside there, so you can have two patterns running simultaneously. So you can have like one laser going up and the other going down, and that's pretty cool. But so that's why you see laser projector 1 and laser projector 2, and a lot of these are the same. So we're just going to mostly focus on projector 1. The first parameter is turning the laser on or off. And for some reason, 255 is also off, so it just has to be somewhere in the middle. So pattern size is kind of the same thing as out of bounds, because you really want to make sure you don't shine this in people's eyes. This is a pretty powerful laser. It's class 3B. So pattern size is where you can like maybe make your pattern smaller so that it's not going to reach the eyes of people. But you know, there's no people here, so we're not going to worry about that. So there's two groups, like I mentioned. There's the pretty drawings, and then there's like geometric shapes. All right, and now pattern selection, you can choose all these preset patterns, and you can't create your own patterns. This doesn't have that kind of software in it. But for like $180, that's not bad. And so you can just scroll through these and choose a pattern you like. I'm going to choose a line. There we go. A line. So pattern zoom. So you can adjust whether you want like the pattern to be smaller, longer, or if you want it to like go in and out and like pulsate. You can choose like the speed of that. So that is really cool. Okay, you can also rotate this. So I can just do like a simple rotate, like I want this straight up and down, or I want it facing the other angle, or you can have it rotating. Pretty cool. It's dancing really fast. All right. And so if you want it moving, so you can like adjust where it is on the x-axis, or you can have it do this. Yeah, it's kind of wonky that it's overlapping. If you didn't like that, you could adjust the pattern size so that was smaller, and so that it's not overlapping at all. And then Y moving is basically the same thing. You can adjust where you want it presented, but then you can also do an animation, and you can do both at the same time. So then that gives it kind of a three-dimensional feel. So kind of similar to X and Y moving is zoom. And so you can play with the parameters, and it does different things to it. Same with the Y zoom. And that really makes it feel like a three-dimensional object. Of course, you can change the color. And this uses RGB color mixing. So to be able to get multiple colors in the same line, you need to either add dots in the next parameter on channel 13, or you need to choose a pattern that already has dots in it. So here's an example. Dots are pretty self-explanatory, adds dots to your pattern drawing. Channels 14 and 15 let you draw the pattern, so you can play with the parameters. So channel 16 twisting works in conjunction with like the zoom or rotating or moving. So like the higher the number, the less of an effect it does. Grading is similar to channel 2. It modifies the size. The bigger the digit, the smaller the pattern. So channel 18 and onward controls projector 2. And a lot of the controls are very redundant, but just a couple of things to note. That the group selection you choose will apply to both of them. So if you have like the geometric shapes on one, it'll also be geometric shapes of the other, and you can do two different patterns simultaneously, and all of the parameters are basically the same. Well, anyways, so that's basically the DMX controls. You can get a lot of control with this, and that is pretty cool. So let's go ahead and do a demo.
When you sleep next to me, I still.
Give you a look at the other side and see like what the actual projection is. Like I mentioned, I'm more worried about like what it looks like towards the audience. Not so much like with the actual shape that's projected, but still kind of cool to see. This thing has a lot of different patterns and effects. No wonder there's so many parameters. It's almost like a global projector, except instead of needing like prisms, it can just kind of do its own thing. So yeah, this is one of the auto modes. You can hear how loud it is. It does have a fan, but it's not a very loud fixture. It operates pretty silently. So I am just letting this demo portion go on for a little bit longer than I normally do, just so you get an idea of some of the patterns that this produces, especially with haze in the air. So let me know if this section is too long or if you would like to maybe see more of the demo in future videos. So yeah, that's my review and unboxing of the Yuking laser. And I like this laser. This is a lot of power. You know, I have not really played with a lot of lasers before, so this is my first laser, besides my Gigabar 2 laser. You know, I like this. This is a really powerful in a small, compact, affordable package. It's really cool. It looks really cool in the air. It gets pretty good range. Lights I review, I like to create a sound switch project with 32 auto loops featuring that fixture. I'm not doing that with this one since I don't plan on using this laser in a show, but I'll leave a project with a few attribute keys that you can download for free to study on my website. Feel free to send me a few bucks to my Venmo if you find it helpful. And if there's any other platform you'd like Show Express, just let me know and I will start creating shows for that if I get enough requests. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. And so if you have any comments, questions, or concerns, leave them down below, especially if you know something about lasers and laser safety. And something I looked up is I tried to scour any sort of a news article of a DJ getting busted for illegally using a laser, and I could not find one. So if you know any stories, I'd be super curious. So leave them down below. Please smash like and subscribe this channel. We're almost at 1,000 subs, and that would be super awesome if we can reach that milestone. And thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video.